Hey everybody, I wanted to take a little bit of time to talk about the reflection number two and working with sources. So I just put this little presentation together, which kind of looks really big right now. Responding with sources. And so first of all, I wanted to say that take your time reading the information. I think we often overlook, especially with the fast-paced kind of life that we live, we don't take time to really think about things, and we often try to go really fast through what we're reading and don't really digest the information very well. So read the three articles carefully, annotate them. You might want to print them out, actually. That's really a good idea. And then think about them, you know. Just don't just, you know, move away from them, but just maybe take a couple of hours, if you have a couple of hours, or a day, you know, before you actually start writing, where you've thought a little bit more about those readings, and look at your notes once again, at least a couple of times. Once you have your notes, you should also take some time to take to write down what your experiences are like, given that this is a topic that you're familiar with. It's all about college and completion and graduation and employment. What do you know about this? And are there any gaps in the readings? Meaning, do you see any parts in these readings where your experience contradicts the reading itself, or the reading contradicts your experience? Take time to write those ideas down. Again, if you don't write it down on a piece of paper, it goes away, and then you can't use it when you want to write your paper. So it's important that when you read, you take notes, and when you think about something, you also take notes. Oftentimes, this is called a brainstorming or free writing, but that's a technical term that often doesn't work for people. But write down your ideas before they leave you. I know that some of my best thinking is done while I take a shower, but once I leave the shower, it's gone, and that's because I can't write it down on the wall somewhere. So write down what you think is my next tip. Once you've done that and you have your notes from the readings, your notes from your own life and your own ideas, you want to think about what your main point for this essay is. You know, you would have to, by this point, think, well, the readings are saying this, and my experience says this, and I'm thinking about this. What's the main idea that I want to present in this essay? And that's really difficult, because you may have a lot, you know, maybe five or six ideas, and what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to pick from those five or six and pick one that you're going to definitely develop and stress in your paper. And by the way, that main point is called the thesis statement. The thesis statement is the umbrella sentence for the essay. It's going to cover basically the entire paper, and the rest of the body paragraphs are going to support that thesis. One thing that you want to keep in mind is that thesis statements are not announcements. So you won't say something like, the purpose of this paper is to do this, that, or the other. Instead, you're going to have a declarative sentence that gets to the point, something like, college is difficult for all students, but especially for those who come in and who are underprepared. That may be a sentence that could work as a thesis. All right. Once you have your thesis, you want to think about the rest of the essay and the body paragraphs. You might want to do an outline at this point, and you want to remember something about these body paragraphs. Body paragraphs focus on one main point. This is what we call paragraph unity. The paragraph is the basic unit of thought in terms of the essay. It's what communicates the main points. It supports the main idea, and they always focus on one main idea as well. And you want to do that with, obviously, with your own writing. You want to include, at this point, either a quote or a part of a summary. When you include a quote or a summary, you also want to include some form of signal phrase that lets the reader know that what's going to follow is source material. It's information that you have borrowed. And then, obviously, don't forget to cite the information. Right. In that signal phrase, you want to remember that you want to say maybe something about the source. Why is the source credible? Why are you using this source? Those are all bits and pieces that you could include in the signaling. that's not it, is it? Well, maybe it is. Once you've done your conclusion, or once you've done your paragraphs, you want to think about how you're going to wrap all things up. And before you move on to anything else, what you want to really do is you want to take some time to read over your paper several times. And again, this is an issue of time, and given that we have 6 weeks only, and so these assignments are coming one right after the other, you may not have a lot of it. But take time to read your paper. Give yourself an hour or so after you finish writing it, where you can read it again and have a little bit of distance. And definitely use your groupmates, your classmates, to share your paper. See if you could get somebody, at least one other person, to read your paper and give you some honest feedback. And in terms of the feedback, you always want to ask yourself, is there a main point in this paper? Are the paragraphs really developed? Is there a voice in this paper? Meaning, do I hear the writer in this paper? And is the information being used correctly? Meaning, is the source information being cited? Are there any gaps that the writer should think about that may need some filling before the paper is fully done? Anyway, I hope this helps, and that's it. Get writing, get going, and remember, you want to turn in your essay through the discussion board, and also through Turnitin, and there are due dates, and those due dates are not changing, because if you blink, it's over. That's the summer semester.